leave the damn thing the way it is.
Listen, Donald Trump's more important than you are. So he gets your phone number.
You know, this is just nothing but bullshit.
It's not bullshit. I'm just trying to give you your new phone number. I'm just trying to do my job.
God bless you. God bless Israel. God bless the Palestinians. And God bless
the phone.
Losers of America. America.
Phone.
Losers
of America. America.
Phone.
Losers
of America.
Look, maybe if you didn't want this to happen, you shouldn't have picked a number that spells Donald Trump.
I didn't pick it. Well, it was given to me.
Well, you could have, you know, said you don't want this one because it's obvious it spells Donald Trump.
America.
Phone.
Losers
of America. America.
Phone.
Losers
of America.
Losers
of America.
Losers. And we live by the sword, die by the sword. The police looking for me. I'ma hide by the broad, shooting stars in my pocket. Pissing on my rocket. I'm wired out the socket. But still shocking everybody. Wanna tell me what I need. You can play a role in my life, but not the lead.
I saw a butterfly in hell today. Will I die or go to jail today?
But it turns out your phone number actually spells the name Donald Trump, and he wants your phone number, you know, just to use for the office.
You know something?
He wants a personalized number.
I'm not really sure I believe you.
What part don't you believe? Hey everyone, you're listening to the Snowplow Show. I'm your host, Arby, and this is episode 430, sponsored by Effin' Reality. That opening song you heard, that was by Riley, Mix, Lux, whatever he calls himself these days, I don't even know anymore. He wrote me an email and said, here's a rebellious submission for the show that doesn't at all listen to that guy from the voicemail, whatever the hell that means. So thanks, Riley / Lux, that was great. So this is the show where we have completely normal and rational conversations with people that occasionally make them say things like,
"Well, you, this is really a ridiculous phone call."
And
who is the asshole?
And sometimes,
"You're calling to tell me you pooped in my front yard?"
And every once in a while, they might say something like,
"At 12 o'clock midnight, fuck you."
Or occasionally, we might get a,
"You are so full of bullshit. It's not even funny."
Or they might state really obvious things like,
"I mean, I've never had a call like this in my whole life."
Or,
"You know what? I think you better take a pill and smoke another funny cigarette and shove it up your ass. Don't you ever call this number again."
And I don't understand why. You know, I'm just calling up people, having conversations with them. They just get all bent out of shape over nothing, usually. So hey, I've got an update on Skunk Works, if anyone's interested in that. Just 2 days ago, there was a brand new update about him. This is a news story from WUSA9, whatever the hell that is.
Story. Remember this Bethesda home where a fire broke out in September? We told you about a strange underground network of tunnels that fire crews found.
Network of tunnels.
A man apparently working on those tunnels died that day.
You might say an intricate network of tunnels.
Now Montgomery County says the house is a danger to others, and they want it torn down. Marcella Robertson has the latest on this story with so many twists and turns.
This story seems to get just more and more bizarre. It's been 4 months since a fire broke out inside this home here. There is still crime scene tape up. There's still a dumpster outside the home. But exactly what happened inside is unclear. Well, now the county is saying that it's unsafe and it needs to be torn down. Meanwhile, the man who died inside the home, his family is still looking for answers.
A network of underground tunnels, bunkers, and chambers.
Network.
That's what's hidden under this home in this quiet Bethesda neighborhood.
That's definitely very strange and kind of scary.
Those details came out after a fire at the home back in September. Daniel Beckwith, the homeowner, seen here on video the day of the fire, made it out okay.
You can't see him at all.
Askia Kafra did not. He was apparently a friend of Beckwith's, working on those underground tunnels when the fire broke out. 4 months later,
so was he a friend, or was he some guy that was being blindfolded while he was driven to the house? I'm still not totally clear on that.
Still surrounds this home. What were those tunnels being used for? All we really know about Beckwith is that he's a self-described hacker, fascinated with all things underground. Now the county is letting neighbors know they want the home torn down. They say the tunnels and bunkers make the home and part of the public street unstable.
It's very sad.
Part of the public street, that means he's dug all the way out to the street. I want to see like maps or pictures or something of these tunnels. God damn it, Skunkworks, you're living my dream.
You know, what was going on in this person's mind that they did all of this stuff. So it's very sad, but now that he's gone, I think that the situation needs to be dealt with and cleaned up.
Meanwhile, Kafra's family is still waiting for answers. No word on a cause
just don't want
of the
him
fire
back in the
or
neighborhood.
How he died. Also, no word on any charges being filed. Fire crews have completed their investigation. Police have not. Until then, neither is releasing any more information. In Montgomery County, Marcella Robertson, WUSA 9.
Beckwith is appealing that decision to demolish his home. There's a hearing scheduled later this month. We'll certainly keep following that story.
So you hear that? Skunkworks is appealing it, which means he is apparently no longer on the run. But it seems like he was at some point because the police were watching his house 2 weeks later after the whole thing happened, trying to find him. So it's kind of a disappointing update. There's not a whole lot of details, just pointless interviews with neighbors. I'm sure eventually we'll get a look at those tunnels. Maybe Geraldo will go down there, try to make his comeback. I'll put a link to that story in the show notes. There's not really much to see in it. It's mostly all about the audio. All you really see is a picture of the outside of his house and one of his neighbors declaring him gone forever. I bet you he was just trying to be safe, like the dad in the Blast from the Past movie. Just making an underground bunker for when the bombs fall. Nothing weird about that. By the way, thanks, Katie Cat, for posting that update on my Facebook. Someone named Zircon posted a link to a YouTube video on the Lil Cricket episode that happened a week or two ago.
Lil Cricket.
When I get so hungry.
He posted a link to this, this song that's on YouTube.
I really
now I gotta listen to the entire thing.
I want
it's so awesome.
For a sandwich or a Twinkie or something cold to drink it.
Cold to drink it.
No, you're supposed to say little cricket
fool. Little cricket fool.
No, little cricket dummy.
Little cricket dummy.
Little Cricket all...
All right, that's enough of that. But Zircon said, LOL, look at the comments on the Little Cricket video and read them. And I did, and they're kind of funny because they're all from us. They're all from PLA people. People saying Cactus. Someone named Chris Sims says, for those that don't know, Little Cricket has a promotion called Fuckface Friday. If you call the cashier a fuckface, you get a free hot dog or a drink. Joey says, Snowplow Show brought me here. Dunk says, bunch of hobos. Curly Burl says, Brad Carter killed JonBenet Ramsey. And JonBenet Ramsey says, agreed. God damn it, that's going to haunt me for the rest of my life. I'm a new listener to the Snowplow Show, but I don't get the cactus references. All right, that's a good place to post that. I Am Not Goomba says, you think a cricket can stop me? Ah, ha, 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 ha. Yeah, I do a great impression of that. Roy the retarded boy, cactus, cactus, obey the cactus. Roy Gerbil brought my ass here. Corporal Dan says, I don't go to this place for gas anymore. Last time I went, there was something wrong with the pumps, and it sucked all of the gasoline out of my car. And Curly Burl says it even took the air out of my tires. Haywood's like, at 12 o'clock in the fucking midnight, fuck you. Yeah, it just goes on and on. It's like nothing but comments from you guys. And I'll link to that video in the show notes if you want to check them out yourself. I didn't read all of them. There's a bunch more. Oh, and speaking of Lil Cricket comments, we tried to liven up their Facebook page, but it's just completely dead. They don't respond to anything there. None of their customers would respond to anything we said to them. There's a Facebook page called facebook.com/lilcricketstores. And there's stuff on here like from Jeff. It says, if I won the lotto, I'd buy donkeys to feed to the homeless. Good one, Jeff. Brad says, I tried calling you guys. Why are your phones such a poopy? Stop using Cricket Wireless as your phone provider. I don't know. I don't want to go through all these, but I'll put a link in the show notes if you want to read them. It's somewhat amusing. But don't try getting a response from the actual people that manage that page. They haven't posted anything since about 2013. Okay, enough Little Cricket. Let's do some calls or something.
Let me have your name.
It's Sensei Doug. I've got a list of numbers here from Naglerr. He says, hey Brad, I've decided to look online and see who's looking for a roommate from hell. Turns out there were a few people on sites that didn't give out phone numbers. I sent general message directing them to the prank line. Oh shit, someone's actually using the prank line. I'm gonna check that right now. Looks like I don't have any voice messages, but there's a few text messages in here. Maybe I'll get to those after. He says the message he sent to everyone was, "Hey, I just relocated to the area from Massachusetts. I'm looking for a place to stay for a couple of weeks until I get an apartment or something. Please give me a call. I can pay in advance. Thank you, Roy." And then Naglerr says he also collected a series of phone numbers. While compiling this list, I thought of a few humorous ideas. Feel free to do them or ignore them or whatever. And he wants me to ask if I can pay in Bitcoin. Many of these people include utilities, so try the water infinite energy thing. So, okay, let's call the first one on the list. His name is Tony. $100, fully furnished rooms for rent, north side.
Hello?
Hello, Tony?
Yeah.
Hey, it's Roy. I was calling about that roommate thing.
Yeah.
Is that still available?
Yeah.
Okay. So how
when
do we...
When do you need one?
Huh?
When do you need a room?
When?
Yes.
Oh, like as soon as possible. I'm just kind of living out of a motel right now.
Today, tomorrow, Wednesday,
sir. Oh, hey, don't be a dick about it, motherfucker.
Who are you talking to?
I'm talking to you, motherfucker. You don't talk to me like that.
Oh, my God.
How'd you like to wake up one of these nights and just have me standing there staring at you? Oh, he doesn't like that. Crap, I think I fucked that one up. I'm sorry, Naglerr.
Hello?
So, what's the address then? When can I come and look at it?
Bro, you just cussing me out about my shit, bro.
Yeah, well, you're getting an attitude with me.
I don't, bro. I asked you when you need the room. I said today, tomorrow. Soon as possible means can be now, today, tomorrow, whenever, bro. I just asked you when you need it.
Okay,
I didn't disrespect you.
Listen,
I don't need you.
If you're going to be a grouchy roommate, bro,
you just disrespecting me, bro.
If you're going to be a grouchy roommate, I'll get you kicked out. I'll have to ask you to leave, and I'll just live there by myself.
Ask you to leave what?
Like, after I move in, if you keep being grouchy like this, I'll make you leave. I'll work it out.
Listen, man, don't call my phone, bro.
Well, I just
don't want your roommate. Don't call my phone.
What would you put an ad up for if you don't need a roommate? Holy cow, was I in the wrong there, you guys? Like, I thought it was him that was getting all grouchy with me. I think he started it, okay? It wasn't me that started it. Okay, next one. The main image on the ad is one of those inspirational text images, which is in a typewriter font. It says, "Everything will be okay in the end. If it's not okay, it's not the end." And then in parentheses, "unknown." You know why it's unknown? Because it's stupid. So I think I would get along with this person perfectly, because I love people that hang up giant framed photos of inspirational text on the walls, put that shit all over their house. It's awesome. That's my favorite thing. He says, "Hello guys, if you need a place to stay, come on, this room is $110 a week. You must pay a $75 deposit on the day you move in, plus the first week's rent." These seem pretty cheap. I want to go live there. I want rent that cheap. $110 a week? That sounds awesome. New paint, bed, TV, internet, cable, and phone. Everything you need. You can have your own room. Share the kitchen and the bathroom. The house is off. Thanks. See, what do you mean the house is off? The house is off? Okay, whatever. I'm going to call this guy. Oh, is this a female? It says Miss K. K. Hello?
Hello?
Oh, hey, is this Miss K?
Yes, it is. How you doing?
Pretty good. I was just calling about that room for rent.
Yes. How soon are you looking to move in?
Just as soon as possible, I guess. I'm living in a motel right now.
Oh, yeah, you need to save some money.
Yeah, it's pretty expensive living here.
Yeah, it's too expensive. I'm only charging $110 a week.
Yeah, I know. That's a really good deal. Is it a nice neighborhood and everything?
Yeah, it's real nice and quiet. Where's your job located?
I don't have a job quite yet. I'm still looking, but I have a lot saved up. I have enough for at least 6 months, so I'm just out there doing interviews and everything right now.
Oh, okay, then, cool. So when you want to come over and take a look?
And then also I do a lot of independent science stuff. Like if I move in, is it okay if I bring, I have a very large collection of bed bugs, live bed bugs and aquariums.
Uh-huh.
So I'd be bringing about 500,000 bed bugs into the house.
Oh, bed bugs.
Yeah, bed bugs. But it's an experiment. God. It's for science. It's okay.
Oh, okay. They're not going to come out of there.
Well, you know, I've had a few accidents in the past. Once I accidentally knocked over a shelf full of aquariums and they got all over, They you know, they got loose, and the apartment I lived at, they kicked me out.
Oh.
But okay. Yeah, I think okay. I've learned my
well,
lesson.
Let me talk to my husband, and let me get you a call back, okay?
Okay, all right. Just yeah, ask him if $500,000 she hung up. I kind of get the feeling she's not going to call me back, and I want to talk to her husband. I want to be like, hey, what's it feel like to live in a house that has just inspirational text everywhere? And why don't these people have pictures of the actual place that's for rent? Like, so far, neither one of them have had pictures of what the place looks like. Like, it's all just a big scam or something. Oh, look at this. I just put her phone number, Miss K's phone number, into Facebook, and it pulls up her profile, and it says she's single. She doesn't have a husband. And hey, what do you know? Look, it's a bunch of inspirational text images on her feed. And there's a picture of her in some insane Halloween costume. Wow. She seems like a high-maintenance roommate. Okay, next, we've got Rusty. Rusty makes his post in alternating capital letters and lowercase letters. Like every other letter is... Oh, wait, no, he's doing the vowels in lowercase, the consonants in uppercase. Wait, no, I thought there was a pattern, but nope, I'm wrong. It's random. That was just a coincidence. And he actually has pictures. There's a picture of the garage, and there's two guys playing ping pong together. And there's a blacklight poster on the wall, and there's a lot of pictures in here. A lot of bros doing bro things. There's a guy on a motorcycle. It's a big house. 2,300 square feet. All right, let's see if Rusty answers.
Your call cannot be complete.
He puts periods in his phone number instead of hyphens. That always fucks up my asterisks. Oh, it actually says 420 friendly on here. That explains the blacklight poster.
Hello?
Hey, Rusty?
Yes.
Hey, Rusty, are you still looking for a roommate?
I had an interview last night, and this person's, he's going to come meet the rest of the people at the house. You know, if that doesn't go well, then yes. But right now, not this second.
Oh, okay. So, like, I should call back maybe tomorrow or something?
No, just... you can text me your name, and I'll just save it to this number, and I'll just let you know tomorrow.
Okay, I can do that.
All right, man, thanks.
Hey, the water is included, right? It says here the water is included?
Yes, yeah, it's utilities, Wi-Fi, cable, everything.
Electric?
Right, everything.
Hey, could I exchange, instead of paying rent, like, I've got a giant water reservoir. It's like a huge tank of water, and it generates electricity, and it just
no,
it
I
uses...
Don't,
it, no. Oh, no, it's cool. It's free electricity. It just uses up about 300 gallons of water a day. But other than that, it's completely free electricity.
That sounds good, but this is just one of many rental properties I have, man. It's a business, so I don't do exchanges.
Yeah, but, you know, like, if you don't have to pay an electric bill anymore. Like,
I gotta go, man.
Shut up. My apartment building, they're kicking me out because they don't like the water reservoir because I was using up all the water.
Take it easy, bro.
Hey, motherfucker. All right, that didn't go well. I think this is about as well as would probably go if I was trying to find a roommate in real life. I should probably just stay where I am forever. Probably. If I ever go out there and start looking for a roommate, I'll be sure to record the calls for you guys. If I'm looking for a roommate for real, we can compare it to these calls someday. All right, here's a guy, room to rent, $100 a week. These are around Jacksonville, Florida, by the way. I don't know if rent's just really cheap down there, but $100 a week if you want a roommate. Apparently, it always includes every utility. I can't believe what an idiot that last guy was. He doesn't want free electricity on his properties. I could set him up with a giant water reservoir on every property. He'd never have to pay electric again. Just 5 billion gallons of water a week, or whatever it is. Pays for itself.
You have reached the voicemail box.
No answer on that one, so I'll save that one for later. All right, here's one that is females only. It's a very sexist operation here. $410 for a furnished room down the street from some of the best restaurants in Jacksonville. You have your choice between an open bedroom or a large back room. What do you mean an open bedroom? What's that mean? Bedrooms can be furnished or unfurnished. The roommate is female, late 20s, professional. Oh, this one doesn't include utilities. You gotta pay the water and electric. Split it in half. Internet is free. Probably stealing it from the neighbors or something.
Hi, you've reached 40.
Okay, so that person's not answering, but that's okay, because the next person, Brooke, she is also a sexist and only wants a female roommate. $700, looking for a female roommate to move into a gorgeous new home. She is the homeowner and another friend. lives there, 3 bedrooms, 2.5 bathrooms. We're both professionals who work with children and are looking for a non-smoker roommate with no pets, who is very clean. Sounds like a germaphobe. I wonder if bed bugs count as pets. I'm gonna be like Tom Hanks, where he dresses up as a female and moves into the female apartment building. You guys remember that show, right? I can't even remember what it was called.
Hello?
Hi, Brooke?
Yes.
Hey, I was calling about that female roommate thing. Is that still available?
Yes, at the moment.
Okay, great. I'm definitely interested in that. I'll be available in February. That's right around the time I'm going to be moving out of my current place.
Oh, awesome. I'm sorry. I'm leaving on a trip at the moment, and I'm about to board a plane.
Okay.
So I'm terribly sorry. I can't talk at the moment.
Okay, well, what's the address? Can I go peer in the windows?
Oh, I'm sorry. It's still being built.
Ah, balls. Okay. Well, I'll call back. I'll call back soon, I guess.
Okay. Sounds great. Thank you.
Where are you going?
On a trip.
Where to?
Far away from Jacksonville.
Which airline?
I don't know at the moment.
What's the flight number?
Have a wonderful day.
Well, hey, you don't have to lie to me to get me off the phone. Going on a trip. Yeah, right. I don't know. I guess, should I save that one for later? I guess I will. I mean, if I call back tomorrow, she's not going to be on a plane still, right? And damn it, that's the last female one. Next, we've got $125 a week, a nice spacious room for rent, clean, quiet, drug-free environment, and the end of the ad tells me to have a blessed day, and his name is Brian.
Hello?
Hello, Brian?
Yes.
Hey, it's Roy. I'm calling about that roommate. Is that still available?
It's not, I don't have a roommate situation. It's just a room for rent.
Oh, okay, just a room. I see. So I'd be living by myself.
No. There's other people that live.
There's what?
There's other people that live at the residence.
Oh, okay. So it's kind of like a roommate thing then.
Yes, sir. There's other people that live there.
Oh,
yes,
okay. Sir. All right. Yeah, this is so confusing. Hey, is it okay if I, how big is the room?
What are you calling about? I got a couple of them on there.
Oh, I don't know. None of them really talk about square footage. I just need room to bring in a lot of scientific experimental equipment and computers, giant racks of equipment, lots of chemicals, lots of tables, chemicals, shelves.
Oh,
I don't fit that. Yeah, like the closet. Like, is there good closet space? I have a few biohazard suits.
Oh, okay. No, I don't have anything on that line.
And I'm going to need
just regular size, little bedrooms.
Oh, yeah. No, bedroom sounds good. Is there roof space available? Because I need to mount about 3 of those really large satellite dishes on the roof, like those big 12-foot dishes, you know, like they used to have in the 80s.
Oh, no, I don't allow that type of stuff, sir. I'm sorry.
Oh, okay. Well, I'll just put them in the yard then. Is there a lot of yard space? He hung up.
Hi, you've reached 349.
Now he's not picking up. Thinks he can discriminate against me just because I'm a scientist. Who does he think he is? You guys, all this talk about roommates is really making me lonely. I think I'm going to go on the air right now, turn this into a live show, because this is a pretty big list. I don't want to sit here alone for the next hour and do these. Hey, you guys, I'm going to do a show. But, you know, first, let's listen to a little bit of Billy Joel here. I'm almost ready to get going here, you guys. Just give me another minute, setting a few things up. In the meantime, let's listen to some Billy Joel. I'll probably start after this song. Hi! So I'm calling roommates today. I got a list from Naglerr. And Naglerr provided me with a bunch of people who are looking for roommates in Jacksonville. So we're going to do some roommates. There's maybe 20 numbers left in this list. And I was trying to call up female people, females and, you know, female-only places and try to be a roommate there, but none of them were working out. This one lady didn't have time to argue with me because she was on a plane. It was bullshit. And this first guy I called, he got really pissed off and yelled at me a bunch. I'm going to call him back real quick. Just let him know that I've decided I'm not interested.
Please leave your message for...
He's turned off his phone. Never mind. Free chemo machines gave me an idea. I think I'm going to tell him that Carrot Top's going to be their roommate. You know, I'm like Carrot Top's manager or something. Tell him how wacky it's going to be. He's going to hang props everywhere or something. I don't know.
Hello?
Hey, Brian? Brian? Brian?
Hello?
Hey, Brian. I was calling about that room situation thing. Brian? Okay, yeah. I talked to him right before I went on the air. I guess I forgot to delete that one. He had a thing against scientists. He didn't want me or my experiments in the house. So, forget that one. Pretend that never happened. This next one has no name. It says, do not bring furniture. Perfect to ask about wacky science experiments. I'm not sure why that's perfect. Here, let's read the ad real quick. So I think, oh man, this posting's been deleted by its author. Well, I'm going to call it anyway.
Hello?
Hey, I'm calling about that roommate ad you put on Craigslist.
Right, and where are you going to be working? Let's see if it's close enough.
Hey, settle down, okay? Hey, I'm not interested.
What?
I said I'm not interested. Oh. I'm not interested. She just hung up. What's she going to hang up on me for? I'm calling right back. And why'd she remove the ad? It sounds like she's still interested.
What is it then?
Hey, that was very rude of you to hang up on me, and I think that just helps me...
You sound very rude, as a matter of fact. You sound very rude.
Well, you're just confirming for me that I made the right decision in deciding that I don't want to be a roommate with you. There she goes again. All right, next is Mark. Let's see what Mark's ad says. What, really? It's been deleted too? Shit. I don't know what to say to deleted people.
Hello?
Hey, Mark, I'm calling about your roommate ad on Craigslist.
Hi, how are you?
Pretty good. I see you're looking for a professional male over 30. That's very, very specific.
Appreciate that. What was your name, sir?
My name is Roy.
Roy?
Yep.
All right.
Yeah. Woohoo!
So where are you living now in Jacksonville?
I'm staying in a motel. I just moved down here from Illinois. I have a warrant, so if I'm within 45 minutes of the state, they can extradite me back to county jail, and I don't want that. So I'm just going to be laying low here in Florida.
You have a warrant out for your rent?
Yeah, but it's just in Illinois. Like, it's not a big enough crime where they're going to extradite me from Florida.
Well, it's a big enough crime not to come into my house.
Well, hey, motherfucker, don't get an attitude.
You have the wrong number, sir.
No, I don't have the wrong number. You have the roommate thing up on Craigslist.
I do have a roommate thing. It's this professional male that works in his transportation.
I am a professional.
And they take care of himself.
I'm a professional.
Nothing is worn out.
I always take care of myself.
There are 1,000 other rooms for rent. Go look for them.
Why can't I look
Good
for
luck,
yours?
God bless
you. You're discriminating because I'm black. And what the hell? Like, I'm looking for a professional male over 30. Must be employed, have transportation, and that's it. The rest is up to you. I make it very easy for you to move in. I bet you do, if you know what I mean. Why do you have to be a professional male over 30? That's weird. So you think he is. All right, no name on this next one. SOSE_STK, Mr. Stupid Name. I think that's an acronym for stupid name somewhere in there. Sorry, I shouldn't say that. But they said a roommate wanted. I'm in, motherfucker, but if I move out, I'm taking the fucking cat. And that sounds funny. Like, I'll find out if they have pets. Just let them know that I'll be taking the pet if I move out. They have to sign a thing. Thanks, stupid name. All right, $520 furnished room. Nice, clean, safe, quiet, furnished room, free drugs. Oh, no, it says free of drugs and alcohol. And drama, zero tolerance in all caps. Behind gate, gas station, $50 application fee, washer, dryer, cable, utilities. I'm going to call and ask about the free drugs.
Hello?
Hey, I'm calling about that roommate thing ad on Craigslist.
Yes, it is still available.
Oh, that's great. It is still available? Is that a yes?
Yes, it is.
Oh, yay. And I see here that you say you provide free drugs and alcohol.
Yes.
On the Craigslist ad, it says free drugs and alcohol.
Correct.
What kind of drugs do you give us? And what kind of alcohol? What kind of drugs and alcohol?
The host is free of drugs, alcohol, and drama.
Oh, that's a...
You need to read good.
That's weird that you're giving away free drama, but I'll take the free drugs and alcohol. Hell yeah.
Okay.
Let's party it up. All right, there seemed to be a language barrier with that guy. Next is Mike. Mike's ad is $200 a month. Wow, that's cheap. With help for babysitting duties. Looking for a female who would be able to pick up my kid from school before 6 p.m. 2 to 3 days a week. Why a female? Seems very sexist. Would have to discuss details and agree to a background check since my child would be involved. She is currently in preschool. Let's work out the details. Huh. I don't know where to go with this one. Maybe I'll do the carrot top thing on this one. Or what's an insane female celebrity like Sarah Silverman? I don't know. Who's just like a nightmare of a...
Hello?
Hi, Mike?
Yes.
Hey, I was calling about that roommate ad on Craigslist. Is that still available?
No, actually, it's not. I found somebody already.
Oh, really? Is she cute? Do you think it could turn into something more than just a roommate situation?
No, probably not.
Well, you never know. Got to keep your options open there, you know? Just treat her nice and maybe, just maybe, one of these nights. Is she single, or she taken?
Yeah, kind of something like that.
Oh, she is single, or she is taken?
Single.
Ah, cool. You got to put the moves on her. Is she, like, age appropriate for you? Like, around the same age?
Something like that, man.
Oh,
I gotta go.
Nice. You want to, like, maybe get together, do a three-way type deal, maybe? You know? Nope. Apparently not. That's just weird, isn't it? All these people asking for, like, specific types of people. Kim Kardashian. That would have been good if they... Let him know that a bunch of camera crews are going to be moving in. Okay, creep dude who wants pics of females looking for a room want adult release? Wait, what? Okay, hold on. That's just what Naglerr wrote in this email. I have to click on the thing. Oh, it's been deleted by the author. Should I call him anyway? Have extra room for female, the title says, but it's been deleted. Stallman, I did that on the one right before I went on the air. I said I was going to put three giant satellite dishes on the roof. And
Leave your message for...
He had a problem with that. He ended up hanging up on me. He is not a fan of science. Ah, this next one's been deleted too. What the hell, Naglerr? Sending me a bunch of deleted posts. He did send me this 3 days ago, so it's my own fault. Are people even allowed to specify female?
Hello?
Hello, Rudy?
Yes, sir.
Hey, I was calling about that roommate thing on Craigslist. Is that still available?
Yes, it is.
Okay, great. I noticed the ad's been removed. What happened?
What do you mean?
It says it's been deleted by the author. Weird.
I just saw it just now. I don't know.
Huh.
I still have it available.
It's that damn...
You want to come and look at it.
Net neutrality, I guess. Yeah. Well, it's actually not for me. I'm an agent here in Hollywood, and one of my clients is wanting to move into there. Would you have any problem with Carrot Top moving into your place?
A what?
Carrot Top, he's a famous comedian / actor, writer, songwriter, singer.
Is this a joke?
Oh, no, it's not a joke. Do you know who Carrot Top is?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, he's...
The one with the suitcase that pulls out and makes jokes.
Yeah, pulls out the what?
Yeah, the one that makes jokes and all that fun stuff.
Oh, yeah, with all the props. He's going to be bringing a lot of props to the apartment.
It's a house, actually.
Oh, okay, house, whatever. La-di-da. But yeah, how much is it? Because, like, seriously, when I go to this ad, it says it's been removed.
$675.
Okay.
First and last.
Okay, yeah, he can. I think he can probably swing that. He's just going to be in Jacksonville for about a year. He's moving his show from Las Vegas to Jacksonville.
Right on. Cool.
And, I don't know. It's going to get pretty wacky around there, though. I hope that's okay.
No problem. I have a dog if he's okay with it. He's a female boxer.
Well, he's going to insist that you're going to have to sign some non-disclosure agreements and stuff.
No problem.
If that's okay. And also, when he does move out, he always does this with roommate situations. He will be taking your dog with him.
No, he won't.
Oh, yes, he will. No, it's going to be in the contract. You won't have any legal right to stop him.
Oh, okay. Then I'll look for somebody else then.
Well, no, look, he can pay more than what you're asking, if that's the issue. But he definitely wants to keep the dog when he moves out.
No.
Why not?
Nope.
What's the problem?
Because it's my dog.
But you said it's a puppy. You're not even attached to it yet.
It's over a year, sir.
Well, he uses dogs in his act. Like, it'll have a good life and everything.
All right.
Killdeer says he's a registered poodle file. Call him right back.
Hello?
Hey, Rudy. Okay, final offer. He'll pay $3,000 a month. But he gets the dog.
Have a good day, bro.
Wait, no, look. Come on, it's just been a year. Are you really that attached to the dog? It's just a dog. It's not like dogs have feelings. They're not real. Basically robots. Like on The Good Place, they explain that on The Good Place. Dogs aren't real things. They're just programmed to think they are, you know? That's all. Next one has no name. It's old people, it says. That's weird that his... Okay, what's going on? Because I'm... This one says it's been deleted by the author, too. That's weird. Here, let me post it in the window on my other computer. It's been deleted on that one, too. Maybe they found someone. Carrot Bottom.
Hello.
Hey, I'm calling about the Craigslist roommate ad. Is that still available?
It will be probably about midweek. Next week.
Okay, great. Yeah, that's perfect. How much is that going for? Like when I click on the ad, it says it's been removed. Did you remove it?
Nah.
Oh, weird. Because I wrote down the number yesterday, but now when I go to it, it says it's been removed. That's
it's $400 monthly.
$400 monthly, and that includes utilities?
Yeah.
And is there an age limit?
Well, we're 50. I'm 54, and I have a female roommate.
Okay.
She's 52, as long as you're compatible, respectful, and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, it's actually not for me. It's for my son. He's 11 years old.
Yeah, we don't want any children, man. That wouldn't work.
It's well, no. He's really mature and everything. He's a piano. Pardon? He's a piano virtuoso. That's what they say in the chat room. He plays. He has a job and everything. He plays piano. He does concerts and everything.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, he's very mature 11-year-old.
We just not can't deal with kids.
He's got a girlfriend. He's got a girlfriend, but she's not going to stay over too often.
Yeah, I just can't deal with kids. I'm sorry, buddy.
Why? Like, what do you have against kids?
Nothing. Don't want kids around.
Why not? What are you doing? Like, you walking around naked or something?
No, pervert. I'm not walking around naked.
Well, you're the one that has a problem with kids. Like, what's the problem?
It doesn't matter. If I didn't want dogs, I don't want dogs. There's no difference.
Okay, look.
Why would you argue?
Are you a sex offender? Is that the problem? Are you not allowed?
No. That's why I need a background check from you to see if you are a sex offender.
No, I'm not.
Dipshit.
I'm not a sex offender. You're the one that can't be around kids, apparently.
No. I don't like them around. I can't stand the little brats.
Did like your dad hit you or something when you were a kid?
No, your dad must have molested your little punk ass.
Whoa.
You got your dick in your hand right now?
Whoa. Where's this going?
That's where you wanted to go, you stupid fuck.
Where'd that come from? No, it's not me. It's you. You're the one that's like afraid to be around kids.
You think you're going to get... If you're calling for a room and somebody says they don't want something, you move on.
Think you're going to get arrested or something
just because
of kids
around. their authority. It's my fucking house. You'll never make it here anyway, punk.
Oh,
so
yes,
see you
I
later,
will.
Bitch.
You know what? You know what? I'm going to dress him up like an adult, and you won't even know. And I'm going to call from a different... Okay, there he goes. That sure escalated. So I went to this posting... Okay, all right. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to post that ad on the Mixler, and I want you guys to go to it and tell me if it's broken for you, if it's been removed by the author. Because I just went to it in Firefox. It's also removed in there, but that guy said it wasn't removed. And some of them are coming up, but why isn't this one? It's very strange. Super Phone Bros says it's deleted. Brothers, I mean, sorry, I shouldn't say bros. Yeah, everyone says it's gone. It's not just me. Okay, I feel better then. It's not any, like, weird, crazy, I don't know, malware shit on my computer. Thanks, everyone, for checking.
Hi, you have reached 3-4...
He won't pick up now.
Hi, you have reached...
All right, whatever. It's weird. I've had like 3 or 4 people yell at me today from these roommate things. They get really pissed off. Don't know why. All right, this next one is not a deleted by the author post. $600 spacious master bedroom / private bathroom. It's got pictures. This is a really nice place. Got big picture windows, wraparound windows. That's pretty neat. Looks like it's on the first floor. Perfect for digging a tunnel underneath the house. Full use of the kitchen, living and dining rooms. Sharing the house with 2 other professional males. Background checked, no smokers, couples, drugs, or pets. They have something against couples. No name on this one. Tim wants me to say I'll be bringing my vacuum chamber that I sleep in. It has a pump that uses a lot of power, so they're going to need to chip in extra for the electric bill.
Hello.
Hi, I'm calling about the ad on Craigslist about the roommate thing.
Oh, right. Yes. So it's the master bedroom in a 3-bed, 2-bath home.
Okay, great.
Got its own private bath.
I see it's on the ground floor. Is there a basement?
Did it say that? No, there's no basement.
Okay,
in Florida.
That's good. That's good. Yep. Good to know.
So it's just that there's 2 professional males that you would be sharing with,
mm-hmm.
but the master bedroom is kind of self-contained. Really, it's got its own bathroom and shower and a whole lot. So.
Yeah. Yep. I noticed the very large closet. That's like a kind of a walk-in closet, right?
Yeah. There's actually 2 closets.
Oh, nice. Oh, yes. I see that now. Okay.
So plenty of storage.
Perfect then. Yeah. Well, I want to use the bigger closet. I'm going to put a hole in the floor, and I'm going to excavate down below the house underground, and I'm going to be building a bunker and some caves and an intricate network of tunnels. No, I'm serious. This is professionally, I'm an excavator,
wow.
And I like to just keep in practice and everything. It's not going to make a mess in the house itself.
It shouldn't make a mess at all, actually. No,
it'll be very clean. I'll just take the initial dirt out, and then after that, I'll do all the excavating underground, and there won't be any need to bring dirt up.
Well, there could be a little problem with the foundations,
No, it's cool. It's just like one single hole in the middle, so it's not gonna hurt the foundation. It's not gonna, mess with the house. It's fine.
Yeah, that's a good one.
No, I'm actually completely serious. I sleep in a vacuum chamber. And as you know, that uses up about 1,000 watts of electricity every hour.
Yeah, that'd be a kilowatt hour. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. It's constant. So you're going to have to chip in a little bit extra for the electric. Like, is the electric included?
The electric is included.
Ah, perfect. So I don't have to pay anything.
That's funny.
I'm going to save so much money just for that.
Making my day.
Oh, no problem at all. Glad I could help.
Good job.
But if you're not... Oh, you're hanging up now? Shit. All right. I guess the tunnel thing isn't going to work out, you guys. Fuck. All right. Furnished. Utilities included. Hold on. Let me look at that one again. $600 a month. It's a huge area for $600. I want that. I want to move... You guys, I want to move to Jacksonville. Rent is really cheap there. Really nice places for cheap. But we can't have basements. That guy's like, it's Florida. We don't have basements here. Don't be crazy. Oh, here we go. Female roommate wanted. Let's cue up the Billy Joel. I have a nice room for rent for a female professional or student. The room includes your own private bathroom and use of the kitchen, washer, dryer, completely furnished. Nice neighborhood. $500 a month. No pictures. Oh, and it's Paul. So it's a guy looking for a female roommate. Can't someone get sued, though, these days, saying...
Hello?
Hey, Paul, I'm calling about that roommate ad on Craigslist.
Okay, who is this?
My name is Roy Gerbel.
Okay. I'm kind of looking for a female roommate at this time.
Yeah, I am a female. I'm completely female.
Roy?
Yep. It's French.
Okay. Yep. You're a guy.
No, I'm not a guy. I'm totally a female. I don't know why you think I'm a guy. It's just a weird name, I know, for a female here in America. But I'm a French-Canadian. I've been living here in the States for about, 13 years now.
Oh, okay. You sound like a guy, though, so...
Oh, but I look female. I'm a sexy female, I assure you. Like, why do you only want females, just out of curiosity?
Because I get along better with them. I really don't trust other guys. I have my set of friends, and that's guy friends, and that's the way it is. I get along better with them, so that's the way I choose.
Well, perfect. I usually get along better with guys. Yeah, I'm one of those females. I usually prefer to hang out with guys.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. So, is there any time I could come by and take a look at that or fill out an application?
Oh, wow. Okay. Yeah.
Is this moving too fast for you?
I don't know what to say.
Why is that?
Because you're a guy. I mean, you guy's voice, so...
No, look...
Yeah, I'm just...
Look, I used to be a smoker, okay? And it's been years since I've smoked, but it really did a number on my voice. And, you know, I got the whole menopause thing happening. I'm a girl.
I don't know.
I'm a female.
I don't think so. What? I mean, I'm sorry. I apologize. So.
You said you wanted a female roommate. I'm a female.
Right. Okay. Yeah.
Look,
I kind of know what I'm looking for. Yeah, I don't think
hey,
so. I mean, I'm sorry. So
okay,
anyway,
well, if I come over and look at the place, I'll let you touch my boobs. Prove it.
No. My God. No. I'm not even looking for... No, I'm just looking for a good, dependable female. I mean, I've had girls anywhere from 58 or 60 on down to 20 or 28, you know, not... And they're nothing... sexual. It's just that get along better with them. I've always had female roommates. I mean,
I wasn't trying to be sexual. I'm just saying, you know, I'll fully unclothe so you can see that I'm.
No, I don't want that. I'm not looking for. I'm not even looking for sex or anything physical. I mean, honestly, I just get along better with them. That's what it's about. And I'm looking for someone to share to help me out with expenses and all. So there's no like hanky panky. There's no there's no physical. It's just someone kind of chill type girl, probably in her like 20s, 30s, 40s to hang out with and stuff. And I don't even if they have a boyfriend or if that's fine too. It doesn't really matter to me.
Yeah, I'm sort of seeing somebody.
I can
right
get
now.
Along with, and I kind of know what I'm looking for, so I don't know. I just don't think it'd be a good fit. I mean,
but you
I'm
haven't
sorry,
even seen me. You don't know me.
So.
Like, you don't know what I do for a living. You haven't seen my hot, awesome, sexy body. I'm not trying to hit on you. I'm just saying, you know, I'm a female. I don't know why you'd think I'm a male. To be honest, you kind of sound like a female.
I mean, Like,
are you sure you're a male? You don't sound like a male.
Okay, I think I'm going to go now. I'm sorry. I think I'm going to go ahead and go. Have a nice evening.
Okay, well, you know, don't put an ad for a roommate if you don't want it. There he goes. That was bizarre. At least he was amused by it all. Yeah, Nautical says to contact a lawyer. That's what I'm saying. Like, can you really do this anymore? In this day and age? In 2018, can you say no males allowed or no females allowed? Can't do this. Killdeer wants me to call back as a lawyer. Should I just talk in my regular voice? Or, I mean, I could do the whole voice changer thing. Ah, crap, I'm echoing. Hello, this is, I don't know, what would my lawyer name be? I should just, I don't know.
Hello?
Hello, this is Steve Dave. I'm from the law offices of Steve Dave and Steve Dave, and I understand that you are not allowing females to rent at your property, or males. Well, you know, it's like in this day and age, you can't be like.
you know what I should have done? I should, like, while we were talking, I should have been, what do you mean I don't sound like a male?
Like, right? I mean, a female, not a.
Should have done that. That really messed with his head. Ah, free chemo. I would have seen that. Say you were testing him and that violated the Civil Rights Act of 1964. I should have talked about tampons a lot. Yeah. Great idea. All right, Lisa is looking for a roommate. Her ad gives me a 404 error. Like a little ASCII cow 404 error. That's weird. Greg T. says I should change my voice to a female and then near the end put it to your normal voice. I wonder if I could just, like, slowly move it down and they wouldn't even notice. The thing is, I haven't really experimented with this a whole lot. Like, I don't know which one sounds like a real
female. It's hard to hear myself. Hello! I have menopause! I am wearing a tampon! Woohoo! I'm just gonna sound like a cartoon character. What do you think, everyone? Do I sound like a female with this setting? Alright, here we go. The chat room claims this sounds good. So let's see. Fosco Grub is rubbing his nipples.
Hello?
Hi, Lisa.
Hi.
Hey. I'm really high right now. I'm calling about that roommate thing on Craigslist. Is that still available?
Yeah, it's still available on February 1st, but I have another room too if you need to move in.
Oh, yeah. So is it females only or is it can males live there too?
Huh?
Do I have to be a female to live there, or can I be a male?
There's a male. It's my brother, though. It's my brother. He's really nice.
Oh, is he? Okay. But does he want a female roommate, or does it have to be a male roommate?
No, it doesn't bother him at all.
Okay,
good. Then I can stop with this whole charade thing. I'll just be a male then. Yeah, like, could I come by and look at it then?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, what's
when do you want to come by?
Anytime. Hey, I have I'm a scientist, and I'll be bringing, if I live there, I have this bed bug collection. I have over 500,000 bed bugs. They're all in aquariums. I breed bed bugs. Is that okay?
Bed bug? What's that?
It's a bug that gets into your furniture and eats people. Puts little welts all over your body.
Why are you bringing that?
Oh, I'm a scientist. I breed bed bugs. That's what I do for a living. And they're all in aquariums. They probably won't get loose. You know, every once in a while, one will find his way out. But for the most part, they stay in the aquariums.
Can I look at it first, though?
Sure, yeah. I'll bring an aquarium of bed bugs with me when I come to look at the place.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
And I don't keep a top on the aquarium. They're all trained not to leave the aquarium. I train bed bugs not to leave the aquarium.
That's kind of strange. That sounds kind of...
Yeah, you don't know what bed bugs are?
Yeah, I know what is bed bug, but I never heard that you do that. I never heard of such thing. I know what is bed bug.
Yeah. I have like 500,000 bed bugs. And they're going to live with me.
Wow, that's a lot, don't you think?
Yeah, does anyone else there have pets?
No, I don't like to be honest with you. That house is a virgin. I never but live there with dog or cat. I don't like them.
Oh,
I'm from the Philippines, so I grew up with animals.
Oh, okay, so you know.
I'm very anal. I'm very anal.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice.
I'm very anal. And then... I don't know. It bothers me, the hair of the dog in my couch.
Oh, yeah. Bed bugs are not hairy.
I'm very anal.
Yeah.
TMI. So I kind of like yeah, I'm kind of that person. I don't know. I just don't believe that the animals would live in me or in my bed, because a lot of homeowners, they have pets, and I don't know.
Yes, yep. Yeah, I agree. Yeah, I don't like hairy animals either. That's why I like bed bugs. I just, it's just me and my...
Yeah, so
my
where are you guys living now?
500,000 bed bugs. I'm living in a motel. I just moved here from North Carolina.
Oh, yeah? Mm-hmm.
Yep, and...
Yeah.
Yep, yep. Just living in a hotel. It's kind of expensive.
But, you know, it'd be nice to get a cheaper rent.
What? Yeah, I want you to get a chance to look at the place.
Okay.
Yeah, that sounds great. I'd love to come in. What's the address there? What's the address?
You kind of changed your tone.
Oh, yeah. I thought I had to be female when I first called in, so I...
Yeah, sorry about that.
Well, what's the address there?
The address, I'll text it to you.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that sounds good. Yeah, just text it to this
number, and I'll come on up, take a look at it, motherfucker. Me and my bed bugs.
Okay, I'll take it to you, okay?
Okay, thank you so much. I can't wait for my bed bugs to meet you.
Bye-bye.
Bye. I don't know why the voice changer makes me giggle too much, you guys. Oh, that threw me off, the whole thing. And I just, like, she didn't say she wanted a female-only roommate. I just figure maybe she did because her name's Lisa. But wow, that's the most times in a row any female has ever told me that she likes anal. Just over and over. I'm very anal. Very, very anal. I'm so anal. Liz in the chat room says, in phone context, she would be Lisa the anal Filipino. It's perfect. I'm going to write that down. If I were Matt Hillock, I would be saving that in my Skype as Lisa the Anal Filipino. Tim Ricky wants me to say that I possess magic and I will grant them immortality instead of paying rent every month. That sounds hilarious, but it also sounds like something that they would probably be less believable than me digging holes underground. Only because it's Florida. That's the only reason they wouldn't believe that one. All right, $115. Rooms, room nice is what it says. Nice, quiet, clean rooms for rent. $415 a month. Or couples, $475 a month. Or you can pay by the week. $115 a week. Or $145 a week for couples. No drugs allowed. Please feel free to call. F-I-L-L, free to call. Two phone numbers here. Yes, there is a $50 deposit. Someone earlier said I should say I'm bringing my own room. I don't like sleeping in strange rooms. I'm going to bring my own.
Hello.
Hey there. I was calling about that roommate on Craigslist, that ad on Craigslist.
Yes, sir.
About the roommate. Is that still available?
Yes, sir.
Okay, great. Whereabouts is that located?
It's on East Street, East 27th.
Oh, awesome. Yeah, that's a nice area. But no drugs, huh?
Huh?
No drugs, though, huh?
No, sir. Definitely not.
Okay. Well, I guess it could still work out.
But if you're going to do drugs there...
Oh, no. I guess I'll just... I've been thinking about quitting drugs anyway, so, yeah, I can not do drugs for a little while.
It's not as easy to quit as you think.
Oh, no, I've quit before. I can quit anytime I want.
No drug. I don't want no drug there because a lot of people put the drug over their rank.
Yeah. I'll just.
For me, I don't play.
Yeah. You know what? Like, what I could do is I could lock all my drugs in a metal lockbox, and I'll give you the key, and that way, you know, I can't get to the drugs.
No drugs.
Yeah, but I'll keep them locked away so I can't get them. If I ever need my drugs, you'll know about it because I'll have to get the key from you and then you can kick me out.
No, drugs is something you easily get anywhere.
Yeah.
This is America.
Well, that's true, yeah. But yeah, okay.
And once you're a drug addict, you're always going to be a drug addict unless you go where you're supposed to go, a rehab or something, and get serious help.
Oh, yeah. I've been in and out of rehab my entire life, so I know all about rehab. I can quit anytime I want. You sound like you know where to get drugs, though. I mean, like...
I have no idea.
You've been around the block?
I don't deal with drugs.
Okay, well, that's good, because I am not a dealer either.
Okay.
So, yeah, what's the address? I'd love to come and look at it.
639 East Street.
Oh, okay. That's here in Louisville, Kentucky?
Huh?
That's here in Louisville, Kentucky?
No.
No? Well, where is it?
It's in Jacksonville.
Florida?
Yes, sir.
Oh, shit. Whoa. I thought I was calling Louisville.
No.
I'm like 500 miles off or something. Holy crap.
Oh, okay.
That's cool, though, you know? I've been thinking about moving.
Oh, okay. When you decided to move, then you can... decided to quit drugs, then you can give us a call back.
Oh, no, I've quit drugs. I, like, during this phone call, I'm officially... This is me swearing off drugs forever. No more drugs for me. I'm going to finish up the drugs that I have here today, and after that, I'm done.
Okay.
No more drugs after today, starting tomorrow.
Thank God. I hope you stick to your word.
I'm drug-free, and I found Jesus.
Well, that's nice.
Yep. Okay.
All right, have a good evening.
All right, so can I come by tomorrow then to take a look?
Most definitely.
Hugs, not drugs. That's what I always say.
Well, if you're interested in the house, you can come and look at it.
Okay.
No drugs.
Okay, I won't bring any drugs with me.
All right.
Do you have a mailbox outside?
Yes, we have a mailbox to the house.
Okay, I'm going to leave my drugs in the mailbox before I come in tomorrow.
No.
No. Yeah,
no.
I'll leave them in the mailbox so they won't be in the house.
And I said no. Guess what? I'm not going to prolong this conversation about drugs. You have a good night.
Come on. Why not? I should have seen what her stance was on marijuana. Like, do you consider marijuana a drug? Mob7 wants to know if she considers spice a drug. Yeah, that mumble thing she did at the beginning, that was weird. What the fuck was that? I was trying to imitate her, but it was making me laugh. Oh man, I've been doing an hour, you guys. It's almost time to quit. Gotta quit the show. All right, $500 furnished room in a nice house with a pool. Great roommates. Ooh, a pool. That could double as a water reservoir. dead end street, no crime. Oh, we'll see about that. That's a pretty bold claim to be making, that there's no crime. Room is furnished. Has an extra refrigerator, washer-dryer cable, Wi-Fi, in-ground pool. There's only a picture of, like, a bed in a corner. And that's it. That's the only picture. No drugs, no smoking, no pets, no couples. Male or female is okay. Riley wants me to say that I have a pet dolphin. So the pool is perfect. I am not planning to move, Greg. Or I don't know, I've been looking into places lately. I'd love to move out of Albany. There's nothing holding me here anymore. But places are expensive. I've got a pretty good deal here right now. So I'll probably stick around the Situation Room for another year or two.
Hello.
Hey, Cynthia. I'm calling about the Craigslist ad about the roommate.
Yes, hey, how are you doing tonight?
Pretty good. How are you doing?
I'm doing pretty good. When are you looking for something?
Just pretty much whenever. I've been living in a motel for the past month now. I just moved here from...
Oh, that sucks.
Yeah. No, it's not too bad. I just moved here from North Carolina.
Okay, wow, you've already changed your phone number, huh?
Yeah, I didn't want the North Carolina number, so yeah.
Changed
it to your...
Well, the rent is $500 a month. Mm-hmm. It's $100 for utility, so a total of $600. I run a background check on anyone who moves in. It's a $50 fee for that. There's no deposit, and there's no lease, so there's no signed lease. I do I am looking for someone who's going to be here for, you know, at least a few months or longer.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not wanting someone that's like a week-to-week kind of thing.
Oh, yeah. I'm actually looking for something sort of long-term if possible.
Okay. Well, tell me a little bit about yourself.
I work in an aquatic rescue place, and, they don't usually have me bring stuff home with me. I know you said no pets, but, you have the in-ground pool. Would it be possible to bring an occasional dolphin home with me, just for a few days at a time?
You're funny.
No, I'm serious. It doesn't happen too often, but every once in a while they just don't have enough room for all the dolphins.
Okay.
Over at the rescue.
Yeah, that'd be fine.
Okay.
You could do that.
And there's no drugs. What if the dolphins do drugs?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay. Great. Perfect. I mean, they're smarter than us, so they know better. They're fine
with
drugs.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
Yep.
Yep, then go down the street and score some.
Oh, I thought there was no crime on your street, on the dead-end street. Oh, she hung up. We can go down the street and score some? I think I fucked that one all up. Whoever suggested dolphins in the chat room, it's your fault. Thanks a lot. You run a scream yoga class out of your room? That's from I Regret Jumping. That sounds hilarious. I want to tell someone I have night terrors. Like in that movie, Step Brother. Is run around throwing shit all over the place. Destroying the kitchen. But it's a medical condition. They can't discriminate.
Hi, you reached Cindy.
Ah, okay. I was going to ask her if the no crime thing on their street was a challenge. Shootintard wants me to say that I want to sleep in their bed with them. I think that's Carlito's thing. Carlito used to do that all the time. He'd call about roommates and say, can I sleep with you when I get bad dreams and stuff? I think I may need to steal that from him, though. Got kicked out of my parents' house for sleep fighting. Yeah. Looks like we have 6 numbers left. Kyle and Brandy are a couple looking for a roommate. What the hell? Oh, it's a picture of her and her dog. Okay. She's got, the dog's snout in her hand. It's a very strange picture. Oh, they've got a kitten. When I move out, these are all mine. Oh, she really likes the picture of her holding the dog's snout, because there's that picture on here twice. My boyfriend and I are looking for someone to occupy the 2 open rooms in our home. One is downstairs, and the other is upstairs. So they're looking to just fill up the house with Craigslist weirdos. I wonder if I could rent both rooms. One for me, one for my bed bugs. Both rooms are $400 a month. $400 deposit. Or I wonder if I could move both of my kids in. They both want their own rooms.
Hello?
Hey, Kyle?
Yes?
Hey, it's Roy. I was calling about that roommate ad on Craigslist.
Yeah.
Is that still available?
Yeah, supposed to have somebody come by today to look at the downstairs, but they haven't contacted yet.
Okay. So the downstairs...
But the upstairs is still, definitely available.
Okay, great. I was kind of curious if I could rent both of the rooms.
Just you, or...?
Yeah, well, it's me. I would, I don't know how your basement is, if it's a damp area, but I have a huge collection of over 1 million bed bugs. They're all in aquariums, and I was thinking that would be good conditions for them to live in.
Did you just say bed bugs?
Hey, can you tell
that
lady? You
got bed bugs that you're trying to, have a room for?
Yeah, yeah. It's just aquariums. They would completely cover all of the walls, and they're all in covered aquariums, except for one. I've trained them not to leave the aquariums. But, it's never been a problem. They've never escaped or anything. I mean, one or two here and there, but yeah, I do research for bed bugs, and I breed them professionally.
Oh, okay. Huh.
As long as if any, she don't have to sign a paper.
No, what if...
Hey, Kyle. Kyle, can you tell that lady in the background to shut the fuck up? She keeps talking over us.
Oh, that's my girl, so...
Oh, yeah. Could you tell your girl to shut the fuck up, please?
No.
You and your dirty ass bed bugs. Fuck.
What? Yeah. Why is she being a bitch? my dirty ass bed bugs. And call them back.
You and your nasty ass bed bugs can stay off my phone. Thank you very much.
Oh, hey, ma'am.
Fuck on this fucking number. Bye, nasty nigga. Goodbye.
Whoa, Jesus. Holy shit. Oh, man. Okay. Wow, I feel violated. What the hell was that? I wonder if the address is on here. I'm just gonna come down. Yeah, whatever, lady. Your fingernails. You bite your fingernails. I can see in this clip of you, and your dog's snout. All right, okay. Let's get to the next one. Mylene is looking for a roommate. Wonder if it's gonna be a female. $300 per month, split utilities for a 2-bedroom house, $100 deposit to move in, quite neighborhood, and fenced in. All right, Fetus, I'm doing that idea. Fetus wants me to say, incidentally, I'm a prime suspect in the JonBenet Ramsey case, so you'd be living with a celebrity?
Hello?
Hello, Mylene?
Yeah.
Hey, it's Roy. I was calling about that room for rent.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, is it still available?
Are you still... Yeah, it is.
Yeah, well, no, I'm not a student anymore. I'm 27.
Okay.
But, yeah, so, I'm a professional and have a job and everything.
Okay. So, do you want to see it, like, when?
Whenever. I can't come today, but I could definitely come by tomorrow if that's okay, or any other time this week.
Probably not tomorrow.
Okay. Hey, would you be okay
Maybe
living
Friday?
With a... Would you be okay living with a celebrity?
Celebrity?
Yeah.
What are you talking about?
Well, I'm a prime suspect in the JonBenet Ramsey case. So I'm basically a celebrity. Do you know who JonBenet Ramsey is, right?
Are you serious?
Yeah. I've been investigated for years. They're trying to pin it on me, but I'm pretty sure they're not going to be able to. So I've been on TV a few times. I've been on the news. I was on that celebrity boxing. I boxed Greg Brady once.
And really?
Yeah, he won, but, you know, I could have won. I could have beat him. But, I mean, I just want to make sure that's okay with you.
So
you know?
Why are you just renting the room?
That's just what I'm looking for right now, you know? It's hard to get an apartment when they do the background check, because they Google me and they see all of the stuff about JonBenet Ramsey and how I probably murdered her.
No.
Do you follow the JonBenet Ramsey case?
Ramsey the kid?
Yeah, the little beauty queen that someone killed back in the 90s.
Oh, yeah.
Yep. So, yeah, you know how big of a celebrity I am then.
Oh, you mean you were involved in that?
Oh, no, they're just trying to pin it on me. They just keep trying to say that I did it, but I didn't do it. I had nothing to do with it. Nope. Not me. Nope.
Oh, mm-mm. So you're...
So I was on Dateline NBC a few times. I've had cameo appearances and some reality shows. I basically kicked Greg Brady's ass once on TV, even though he won in the end.
Oh, okay. Well, there's a lady there, older lady, so don't do anything to her, okay?
Oh, no, I wouldn't. Yeah, she's I'm not interested in older ladies. That was an evil laugh. I think I like you.
Are you just joking or just...
No, I'm not. I'm not joking at all. I'm basically a celebrity. I have my own Wikipedia page on the internet, so that makes me a celebrity.
Oh, really?
Yep. I was disqualified in the Greg Brady match because I was biting below the belt. I mean, how many people could you rent to that bit Greg Brady's wiener, you know? I bit him right on the wiener.
Gosh.
So, hey, you single?
Why?
I was just curious, just getting to know you. You know, I feel like I've just been talking about me this whole time. Is it you that lives there, or is like you're saying that it's you and then this other old lady?
I don't live there.
Oh, okay, cool. You're just renting it out?
But this old lady is single.
Oh, is she? How old is she?
60-something.
Ooh, Do you have her, can I get her cell number from you? Maybe, like, just to make sure it would work out, I could take her out on a date tonight?
You're funny.
No, I'm not trying to be funny. I'm just a celebrity, you know? We think on a different level than people like you.
Oh, well, you know, I really don't know you yet, so...
Yeah.
I mean, for me, it's like, I think you would say the truth like that, so I was like, are you being funny? So
oh, no,
that's
no.
What I thought, you were just being funny.
Oh, no, I'll bring my FBI file with me and show it to you if you want.
Okay.
It's a pretty hilarious read.
Yeah, I want to see it.
Okay, yeah, I'll bring it with me. Yeah, so what's your address?
I'll text it to you on Friday.
Okay, that sounds great. Friday's perfect. Can you text me the old lady's number too? What's her name?
No, I can't.
Please? I'm lonely.
So, yeah, if you're really interested in the room, you know, we're going to meet there in the afternoon after work on Friday.
Okay. Hey, on a scale of 1 to 10 right now, how high are you?
How high? What do you mean?
You know, were you smoking a little bit of weed when I called?
No.
Oh, I'm just asking.
I don't smoke weed.
No, I'm not accusing. I was just curious. Just asking.
When you call me, I'm taking a nap.
Oh, you're taking a nap. Okay. You like a late night person? You stay up all night? Partying it up?
No, I get up early, like 4 o'clock in the morning every day.
Oh, cool. Where do you work? What's the number there?
Hey, I don't know you yet.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry. Yeah, you can tell me on Friday. On Friday, you can tell me.
Yeah.
Okay.
On Friday, afternoon, probably around 4:30.
Do you allow drugs at this place, or is that up to the old lady?
No, I don't allow drugs.
Okay, but you know, like, just between you and me, though, you know, wink, wink. Can I? I have a medical cocaine card.
What?
You know, like I'm allowed to get...
No,
it's for medical reasons. Effin' Reality sold it to me.
I think she's working at the hospital, I think. I'm not sure.
Oh. Cool.
So...
She probably has access to real drugs.
No,
this could work out perfectly.
No, I don't allow drugs in my house. Okay.
Okay, but
I just
even if they're you know, I've got a card. I've got one of those cards. I've got an LSD medical card.
Do you know? Okay.
I'm not really sure
about that. I'm not aware of that.
I'll work it out with the old lady. You know, I'll give her some free.
Let's not talk about her yet. Why don't you ask me about the room?
Oh, is it pretty?
No, it's not. It's,
wow.
Do you know where it's at?
No, it doesn't say on the Craigslist ad.
It did. It does. It's in Arlington.
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah. I just meant the street. It doesn't have, like, a street name or anything. It just says Arlington.
And it says it's in a quiet neighborhood.
That's fenced in.
You don't sound... What's that voice?
What do you mean?
It sounded different.
Really? I don't know why it would.
It sounded different.
Yeah. What color is the walls in my room?
I painted the whole house with a white color.
Ooh, nice. That sounds nice.
Yeah.
Is it like an off-white or like an antique white or just white?
Just white.
The last place I lived in,
it had purple walls, but yeah, I like white too. White's pretty cool.
I like white. Light's cool.
Yeah, white is just a basic color.
Yeah. Is there carpet?
Is there, like, are the floors carpeted, or is it just more like hardwood?
It's concrete.
Oh, cool. Even better.
All right, so... just call me, or I'll call you, Friday, okay?
Okay, that sounds great, Mylene.
Thank you so much!
Alright.
And, yeah, you can text me that address, and text me the old lady's phone number, and...
Yeah, that'll be perfect.
No.
No, that's cool.
Alright, so I'll talk to you Friday, okay?
Me and her are gonna get along just fine, it's okay.
All right, I'll talk to you later.
All right, see you Friday with my FBI file.
All right.
Bye.
All right, I think I got carried away with the voice thing. That was a weird call. I gave her PTSD. Yeah, probably. She's probably never going to use Craigslist again now. It's like, fuck this shit. I'm going back to the newspaper. Okay, two rooms for rent on the west side. $500 and $600. Looks like it's a house. It's got a large backyard. It's got a hammock. It's a very nice house. It's got a mysterious room underneath the stairs. It's got a bag full of bags hanging from the doorknob in the kitchen. Looks very homey. It's got two hammocks. I kind of want to call those people back about the bed bugs. They were hilarious. Okay, Sharon. Her name is Sharon, the one renting this house. It doesn't look like a female-only house, so I can't trick her with my female voice. Ben wants me to say, tell her you're wearing a VR headset and you're standing in the room right now. I don't know what that means, but I kind of want to say it.
I'm calling about the room for rent.
Hello?
Hello, I'm calling about the room for rent. Is that still available?
No, thank you.
What do you mean, no thank you? Are you discriminating against robots?
Uh-huh.
What do you mean, uh-huh? What the hell? I fucked it up. Whoever said robot? Yeah, Stallman. It's Stallman's fault.
Hello?
Sharon, you are violating the Civil Acts, Civil Rights Act of 1964.
Look here. Listen to me.
What?
I had a long day. Don't call my phone again, okay?
Look, robots need a place to live, too. And I deserve fuck.
All right, no more robot voice. That just fucks up the calls. Yeah, Americans with Disabilities Act of 1996. Or 1992. I forget which it was. The Metallic Discrimination Act of 2012. Okay, this next one is a 404 when I go to the page. So does that mean... Oh, wait. Oh, yeah, it's because I fucked up. Okay, hold on. My fault. $710 in-law suite with independent entrance. And the first picture is a picture of the independent entrance. Looks like this is an apartment complex with a huge gym and a in-ground pool. Like a huge pool. Oh, wait, no, wait. This can't be just a private residence. There's like a billion treadmills. New home renting their in-law suite with private entrance. Furnished, full-size, own bathroom, small kitchenette. I'm so confused. Proof of income, criminal background check. The pictures do not match what they're saying, though. This is a place. Some sort of a complex. Maybe it's like a community center, you know, like the homeowners have.
Okay, time to call these people. Let's go. Here we go. I'm going to call them up.
Hello?
Hey, I was calling about that room that you had on Craigslist for $710.
Yes.
Is that still available?
Yes. Yes.
Okay, great. Would there be a good time for me to come by and look at it and fill out an application?
Yes, sure. What is that? Friday, maybe?
Yeah, I could do Friday. I've got another appointment on Friday with this old lady, but yeah, probably, I could do this either before or after that one.
What time is good for you on Friday?
Anytime. What time is good for you? Mornings would be good if morning's okay.
Yeah, after 11, I should be free.
Okay. Am I allowed to have people spend the night there?
Like how often?
Oh, not too often. I'm dating a celebrity. His name is Carrot Top. Have you heard of him?
Not really.
Oh, okay. Yeah, he's a famous comedian. Works out of Vegas mostly, but he visits every once in a while, and things get pretty crazy around the house. He's a jokester.
Oh, okay.
Yep. They'll probably be playing pranks on everyone. Yeah, I'm confused about the pool. Is that like a community pool for a bunch of houses, or is this an apartment building?
Yes,
it's like a...
Okay, if you want to call me back on Friday and we can see the time, or actually tomorrow...
Well, I'm walking around the house right now. I'm taking a stroll through it. I've got my VR headset on, and I'm standing in the room right now. It's very nice. I'm looking around. Brown carpets. This is nice. I think I probably don't even need to look at it. I'm looking around in the bathroom right now, underneath the sink. Nice and spacious. Yep. This is really nice. It didn't work out. Ben, CVS, that totally fucked it all up. Let me call her right back. I have to show her proof of income and criminal. Background check. Pretty much nothing worked out with that lady.
Hi, leave your message.
Ah, come on, lady. What kind of message is that? Hi! I was going to tell her about JonBenet, but she didn't let me get to it. She hung up. All right, yeah, I completely messed that one up. Sorry, everyone. Fucked it all up. But I blame Ben. Ben CVS, he's the one that had the dumb VR idea. Which I happen to love, but, you know, didn't work out. All right, $110 weekly room, all included. This looks like a it's a house. It could be split up into apartments. Cable TV, Wi-Fi... Available for a small extra charge. Two-story downtown property. Adults only. No couples, no pets, no children. Long-term availability. The house is safe. If you have to point that out, it makes me wonder. Must have employment. No drugs. Please familiarize yourself with the location. Looking for good long-term tenants. Whoa there wants me to say, I want to rent this apartment so I can spy on the neighbors that live next door. Here, let me see if I can pull this up on Google Maps, because this one just happens to have the full address on it. Oh, or maybe not, because I don't see it. What the hell, they put a fake address in here? Okay, whatever, I'm going to call them up.
Hello?
Hey, this is Roy. I was calling about that room that's on Craigslist.
Oh, yeah, that's me. I'm renting the room.
Oh, okay, great. Is that still available, I guess?
Yes, it is.
Cool. Would there be a good time I could look at it?
Yeah, it's available. You can pretty much to show most days. What's your situation? Is it for yourself?
Oh yeah, it's for myself. I'm living in a motel right now. I just moved here from North Carolina. I have a job already and everything. No drugs, all that. Hey, is the room located in the front of the house?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, it's upstairs. It's upstairs, but it's in the front.
Okay, and so the front window would look out into the front of the yard?
Well, it's up kind of high, so no, you can't even see the yard from way up there.
Well, I'm more interested in the house directly across the street. See, I just got out of a long-term relationship, and my girlfriend, she moved down here from North Carolina, too. So I want to live across the street so I can spy on her.
Okay.
So you know that.
I don't think she'd be across the street, right?
Yeah, well, kind of diagonally a little bit. Like, I think with a telescope, it shouldn't be a problem. I have a high-powered telescope and everything.
Are you serious?
Yeah, yeah. Because, like, would I have access? Is that, like, a deck there on the, you know, outside the windows?
Yeah, you don't have access to the deck.
Ah, darn it. But I could put some listening equipment and stuff out there, right? Like, long-range listening.
Is this a joke?
No, it's not a joke. I have one of those, omnidirectional. What?
No. This isn't. This is either a joke or you're a kook.
No, I wouldn't. Bye. I wouldn't joke. I'm not a kook. I have a job. I'm calling him back. Guess there's not a house across the street from him.
You have reached the voicemail.
So FN Reality says, can you turn your lights off at dusk so I can see better? And God, what a dumb idea. But no, I was thinking I could say I'm one of those people that is allergic to electromagnetic waves. Or Wi-Fi or whatever. So they're going to need to get rid of their Wi-Fi routers. Oh, here's one that has the full address in it. Well, let's put this in Google Maps. Yeah, I could just say I'm allergic to all electromagnetic waves, and they need to just shut down everything electric. They'll get used to it. This one's in more of a private neighborhood. I think they'll probably know who their neighbors are. So I can't say my girlfriend moved in. Let's try that last guy one more time. Oh, yeah, Cody, no name. Line the walls with tinfoil.
You have reached the voicemail box.
Yeah, guy before still not picking up. I wonder if they'd cut down this big palm tree out front. I think it would block my view of Saturn's two moons, if you know what I mean. Hello?
Hello?
Hi.
Yes.
Oh, I was calling about that room for rent. Is that still available?
Yes.
Over there on Harmony?
Yes.
Okay, great. Is this a roommate situation, or is it just like the whole house I'd be renting?
No, it's not the whole house. It's the room. I cannot put. I find some ladies, but I don't want to put ladies over there. And I want to put men because I have another man and one. My sister over there, and I want men. This should be the reason. If some people got cat, dog, I cannot get it.
Mm-hmm.
If somebody dog or cat, I can't get.
I have five dogs. Mm-hmm. I have five dogs. Just five dogs.
So you get five dogs?
Yes, five.
It's not like I don't like dogs, but because the other person don't have.
I have pit bulls.
Sometimes you cannot. Oh, you need a house to rent.
Oh no, it's cool. They live in here in the room with me. They all sleep in my bed.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh,
yep. Yeah, we cuddle. I sleep naked, and the dogs all sleep on top of me.
I understand. Yes, everybody like dogs, but when
pit
you
bulls.
Work a room, they got different people. Everybody don't have. You know, you got to respect everybody.
Yeah,
It's different thing, but when the person went to house, it's different thing.
Yep. So you know the trees in the yard? You know how you have all those trees?
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to need to chop down all of the trees so I can install a radio telescope over the top of the house.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, I'm going to chop down all the trees.
Oh, okay.
Chopping down all the trees. So when can I move in?
When?
I'm a police officer. I can make it up with my left to see. No one trust.
What? Did you say something about Cricket Wireless?
If you want to, you see that you are well, that's fine.
Yeah, yeah.
And,
okay. Bye, honey.
When you need the room.
All right. See you then. I'm hanging up, you guys. I can't understand a word she's saying. Okay, so that's the end of the list, but I have five more here that I tried calling before I went on the air, and they did not pick up. No answer. There was the lady, this one lady couldn't talk because she was going on a trip on an airplane. She was the one that was like females only. Was that a guy? Yeah, maybe it was a guy, Olga. I don't know. Couldn't tell. Connection was so bad I could not tell.
Hello?
Hey there. I was calling about the room you have for rent on Craigslist.
Yeah.
Is that still available?
Yes, sir.
Okay, great. Is there a time I could come by and look at that?
Yeah, tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Okay.
Yeah, after 3.
How many other people live there? Is it you that lives there?
Like 4 people here.
4 people, okay. Do you guys use electricity there?
Yes, sir.
Okay, well, I'm allergic to electromagnetic waves. And according to the Disabilities Act of 1996, you would have to turn off the electric and not have electric there anymore if I live there. Is that going to be a problem?
Electricity, you're talking about?
Yeah, I'm allergic to electromagnetic waves of all kinds. Like, it hurts me. It hurts my body. I get hives and stuff.
I guess, but I don't know.
Yeah, so I'm going to move in there, but we're going to have to turn off the electricity.
No, I don't think so. That's going to happen, sir. You have to find some other place.
No, look, you can't discriminate. It's a disability of mine.
I don't discriminate anything.
Well, you can't discriminate against someone with a disability, and it's a medical condition. I can't help it. But I just can't have electricity. You have to turn off all the electricity. And also, I'm going to cover the entire house in aluminum foil to keep out electromagnetic waves from the neighbors.
Okay. That's a nice joke.
No, I'm completely serious. You should turn off all your lights tonight and, you know, try to get used to it.
Okay.
So what day could I come and take a look? Tomorrow?
Well, I don't think so. You can come and look all day.
When I come and look, can you turn off the power just while I come and look?
Nope.
Okay. I'm going to be wearing a suit, a reflective suit. It'll look like a space suit. Yeah, when I show up, I'm going to be wearing a space suit.
Okay.
Is that okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right, what's the address?
Okay.
What's the address? Tell me the address. Yeah, she wasn't buying it. Oh, well. This next one is females only, but she was not picking up earlier. I wonder if I could talk to her as a female and then, like, my machine keeps breaking down and just showing my real voice. Like, darn thing keeps
messing up. Oh, wait, no, not robot.
Okay.
Probably not going to pick up anyway. Are you having fun, Tim Riggy? That's nice. I am, too. Woohoo!
Hi, jeez. You've reached 408.
Okay. One more time. I tried this number like 3 times earlier and they didn't pick up. So. Yep.
Hi, you've reached 4
balls.
Here's another one. Lady roommate, no answer.
Oh, and this will be the last one. So, yeah, probably not gonna pick up. Oh well.
Hello, this is Carmen Longo with Gloria Homekeeping.
Balls! Balls! Balls, balls, balls. Alright, so I guess that's the end of today's live show. I think we should do this again sometime soon. We should call only female roommate people. You know, ads that say, I only accept females. And I'll do the entire show in this voice. It'll be a lot of fun. That's what we're going to do next time. It'll be the best show ever. Does this seriously sound like a real female voice, you guys? I don't think it does. It sounds weird to me. I don't think it does. It probably, yeah, I don't know. It doesn't sound like a chipmunk, at least. Anyway, yeah, let's have Billy Joel take us out with this hit song from the 1980s. It's called My Life.
Brad, this is Fish Taco.
Hey, Fish Taco.
So I had an idea for you. I know you love those.
Yep.
Totally. So it's a variation of your hang up the phone pranks. Mm-hmm. What the idea is to flip it.
Get
and instead of
it.
Doing hang up the phone, do stay on the line or please hold. And the idea is then that person stays on the line and then you call another number. And then we can see how many people you can get on the line at one time. Hopefully, you get a whole bunch of people on the line, all talking to each other, being super confused and trying to come up with different reasons or scenarios. So, like, what you're actually trying to do.
And when they talk
when
to
you're
each other,
not trying to do
I'll tell them all to shut the fuck up.
It would be hilarious.
Hold the line, please.
All right, take care. Ta-ta.
All right, bye, Fish Taco. I think I can only dial, like, maybe 3 calls at a time, though. Maybe 4. Like, 2 with one of my carriers, and 1 with the other carrier. I don't have a lot of phone lines here.
Hey, Brad. It's Swaptart. I heard a guy call in on the last show, the voicemail, about how he can't find any payphones in Columbus, Ohio.
Mm-hmm.
I am also there, and I can assure you that they exist. They do work. There's not very many.
Yeah,
and
you big
most
stupid.
Are kind of
you
like
big stupid from the other show.
In the suburbs around the city, for some reason, found one outside of a pool once in a suburb near Columbus,
that's
very near.
Nice.
So hopefully
that's
that
nice,
helps
honey.
You there, buddy, and good luck.
Okay, you sure made that guy from the last show look like a big fucking stupid. You showed him.
Hey, Brad, it's Loon. This time calling you from a payphone in Moline, Illinois.
Yeah,
sorry about the last
see?
Payphone.
See, the Midwest. They have payphones there. You big stupid from the other show. Saying there's no payphones in your town.
Sorry, it sounded so
Ohio.
Bad. Anyways, have a good day. Keep up the good work on the show.
Bye. Yeah, okay, you too. Yeah, okay. Sounded good. Didn't sound crappy at all.
Hello, Brad.
Oh, hey there.
Hey, Brad.
It's a kindred spirit.
Hey, Brad.
Yeah, hey.
Bradley.
Okay.
Come here, Brad.
For some reason, the Google translation translates Bradley to Natalie. Isn't that weird?
Please play that Natalie song for me. Please play that Natalie song.
Okay, and right there, it does not translate Natalie to Natalie. It just has a bunch of gibberish. But where he said Bradley, it said Natalie. I think Google Voice is all confused.
Sorry, or at least give us the information.
What's the question?
Bradley!
Yeah, hey.
Yeah, give us the information.
And it's somehow fitting that it's calling me Natalie, because, you know, I'm using the girl's voice thing. What do you want? You want the song?
Give us the information for the...
Go to the Facebook group, find the post where he's talking about Natalie, there's a big quote about Natalie, and I posted a link to Natalie on my computer through Dropbox. So that's where you get it. That's the only place to get it. I'm the only person on planet Earth that still has that song on their hard drive. All right, and I'm tired of your voicemail, so bye. Oh, and look, you left another one. I'm going to delete it.
Hey, Brad. It is Dr. Astronaut. I was just listening to your show. I heard that guy erased your 404 show, so I
what a dick.
popped my spaceship into 12th gear. And then I went about 78 kilowatt hours per hour.
Whoa.
And
crazy.
I went back in time. So I restored all of your 404.
Oh, thanks.
So you're cool.
Weird how my whole site's down today. That's probably your fault.
If anybody wants to listen to 404, they can get in there and listen to it. But now I don't know where I am. So you might not hear from me for a while.
All right. Enjoy the future.
You're welcome.
Bye, Dr. Astronaut.
Hi, I was thinking of nonsensical names. So, let's see.
Natalie.
Like, your last name. Okay, yeah, so you could be like Jimba Shedibushe.
Okay.
Or like, I don't know.
Sounds
like, you could
great.
Be like, my name's Cal Gugnarquin. and then just the spelling on your own. Just whatever. Just make up last names. First name and last name if you want. Hell, yeah, whatever. All right.
All right. Later. Thanks for those awesome names.
Hey, Brad. I'm looking at the spreadshirt.com/phone losers page right here, and you did a really good job. Wow.
Thank you.
And I just wanted to let you know I want this shirt right here.
You don't have to make fun of me, though. You know.
This one.
Tried my best.
And a 5XL if you have it.
I don't know how to design things,
okay? Or a 6XL. That'll give me a little bit of breathing room.
Okay.
But I want this shirt. The one right here.
I'll put it in the mail.
All right. I'll expect that in the mail. Thank you.
All right. I'll ship it out first thing in the morning. You should have it in 3 to 5 days. Enjoy.
Hey, Brad, what did the buffalo say when his mom called?
I don't know. What did the buffalo say when his mom called?
Hurry up, Mom. I'm roaming.
Good one.
What's up? It's Big Moist here again.
Okay.
And just want to let you know, I normally listen to you and other podcasts with the speed at about 1.3 or 1.4.
Me too. But that's too fast. I always do 1.2 on everything. There's only a couple people I'll go up to 1.3 on, because they talk really slow.
I just generally like to hear things a little bit faster. And one time, my podcast app was messing up, and it had you playing at normal speed, and I thought you were having an off day or something, because you sounded really, really slow.
Yeah.
And then I realized that was just me, and I thought it was kind of funny.
Yeah, sometimes I listen to shows that, like, not on my podcast app, and it's weird for me, because they sound really slow. It's weird. Like, their theme song is slower, everything's slower, I don't know what their problem is, and then
but,
I remember.
Besides that, I wanted to ask, why is my name in the Discord censored? Like, it's Big Moist, right? But then it's B-I-G and then M, and the rest of it's just dashes. Like, what the hell? I was Moist bad.
I don't know.
Really?
I didn't.
Did someone else report that? How old are you? Grow up.
Well, okay, fuck you, motherfucker.
Bye.
I'll ask some other people from the corporate office here if they did it, but I don't know why they would.
Hi, Brad. It's Max Power.
Hey, Max Power.
Just wanted to know how the gas station crisis is going up there.
Are people horrible.
Like, literally ready to kill each other over pumping their own gas?
Riots in the streets.
I don't know. Thanks.
Who do they think they are trying to say we have to pump our own gas? Fuck those people. Fuck the government. I ain't pumping my own gas. I don't want to smell like gas all day. That's not my job. That's the job of a gas pumper.
Hi, Brad. This is Dingle Bean, longtime listener, first time caller.
Hey.
I wanted to share a quick interesting story with you. About a year ago, I moved into a new house and I didn't have any furniture or AC, and I was lying on the ground in 90 degree heat, and I was listening to one of your shows about to fall asleep, and you said my name in your show. Obviously you weren't talking about me, but it piqued my interest. I started listening, and you started listing off all the names of my good friends from school.
You're just on drugs, right?
Turns out this is back a couple years ago when you were doing these calls on Facebook, and you're actually on one of my friends' Facebook. Yeah, so you were listening off a bunch of my friends. It was really cool to hear that.
That's crazy.
I'm wondering if that's happened to any other listeners. Just curious. Keep it up, Brad. I'm not a hobo yet. Too poor for that, but maybe one day.
Yep. Someday,
all right, Brad. Thank you.
Someday Bye-bye. You'll be able to afford to be a hobo. And that's crazy, if that's true. I hope you showed that to your friends and showed them where I fucked with them all. But as far as I know, that's never happened before.
I'm sorry that I'm not like other girls, but I will not take myself down to their level. I won't ever, ever sugarcoat the truth. I believe in fighting for what I love, and I'm fighting for you.
All right. Sounds good. Sounds like an inspirational poster that you would frame and put in your living room.
Yo, Brad. I'm calling you from a Southwestern Bell Freedom Phone.
Whoa. Crazy.
Yeah.
Wow.
How's it going, pal?
I'm great. You know? Just hanging in there. Taking it one day at a time.
Love you.
Whoa, that was a hang up.
Hey, Brad, it's DJ Greg calling. Hey, man, you have too many shows now, so I can't really. Yeah, I'm having a hard time listening to them all.
So can't make anyone happy, can I?
Before you didn't have enough shows, now you have too many shows. So I'm going to need you to make less shows, but also keep enough.
You're going to hate this show because it's like 2 hours long.
Shows that the shows are fresh, okay? Does that make sense? All right, Brad, thanks. Bye.
Y'all heard him. I'm going to be doing less shows from now on. I'm going to go down to like 2 shows a week total. Sorry, everyone.
Hey, Brad, it's Copper Dan. There's an interesting new story.
out in Utah, actually southwest Jordan, Utah, for a 7-Eleven. There's been an outbreak of Hep A.
Oh, no.
Essentially, people have been getting infected because there was a coworker there, and they drank out of the fountain.
Oh,
all right, so I think that would be interesting. You know, you just look up the story, and you can probably even get the phone number.
Okay.
Actually, you can, but I'm not going to say
I'll
it.
I'll be like, LOL, you have hepatitis.
All right?
Tee-hee.
Good day, Brad.
Hey, BC Carter. This is Van with the Mail Stripper.
Hey.
I just want to comment on episode 429.
Mm-hmm.
When you had the guy...
Mm-hmm.
Dave from Walmart, I think his name was.
Yep.
When you had him on there while you were doing
it. I called him back on a hobosode, by the way, yesterday. And he accepted my apology, but he wouldn't apologize for accusing me of scamming him.
Calls. I loved it. It made me laugh so much.
He was great.
It reminded me of the time on your podcast, like 10 or 12 years ago, when you called up the old man, the confused old man. And he was like your co-host for that episode of the podcast.
Oh, yeah. Him and his wife.
It was like... It was, It shows that, like, prank calls can become even more hilarious and entertaining in their complexity.
Yeah. Speaking of that...
I just thought I'd make that comment.
Okay. You sure made it. Yes, you did. But yeah, speaking of that, a guy on, I think, YouTube, called The Last Meth Bender, wrote a comment and says, you should call up 7-Elevens or other stores like that, tell them you're with the corporate office, and see if you can get them to do prank calls with you on three-way. So I copied that down into my notes, and I want to do that soon. I want to do an entire show of making various businesses my co-host for every prank, all the voicemails, maybe the intro. I'm going to try that soon. I think that could be a lot of fun. So thanks for that idea, The Last Meth Bender. I'm stealing your idea.
Yeah, why can't I hear the phone number that I could call? Because I'm trying to call him live.
Oh, sucks to be you.
Uh-huh. And I had an answer for a question that you guys were asking. And I can't find the phone number anywhere.
Yeah, yeah. I never posted anywhere. I saw
the phone number.
And today, I did that live show. Somebody was trying to call in, and I was just ignoring him. I'm like, yeah, I don't feel like talking to anyone. The call-in number, if anyone wants to ever call in during a live show, and maybe I'll pick up, but probably not, I call it the request line. The phone number is 505-796-5789. That's also the number that you can call when I do the payphone show, when I'm sitting in my chair answering the payphone. Same phone number.
Hey, Brad, this is Boring Bob. Pretty sick here, so it's
going
there pretty much keeping me happy.
Yay.
Anyways, I got an idea for episode 4.
I hope I'm not doing too many shows for you.
For episode 444, you should do calls to a church directory and kind of like what you told a long time ago. You should say at the next meeting y'all are going to be smoking marijuana and drinking liquor.
Mm-hmm.
And that they need to bring some of their own.
Okay.
And you can screw around with ideas like that. I remember you...
What's this have to do with 444? I'm confused.
Said something about M&M's being Jesus' nuts or something, too. I just found this idea. It says to...
Why 444?
Have someone hide near the baptismal pool with a block of sodium, and at the first mention of fire and brimstone, throw it in.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Thanks, Brad. I'm good.
But why 444? Why? What does 444 mean? Damn it.
Hey, Brad.
Hey.
Born in Bombay.
Hey.
Thanks for using the numbers that I sent you.
You're welcome. Thanks for sending them in.
That's a pretty funny hobo, so first call.
Yep. Don't you all wish you knew what we were talking about? But no, you don't know, because you didn't hear the hobo so that I put out yesterday that was really, really funny. I called up customers of a consignment store that Gordon Bombay sent to me. And I managed to piss off one guy pretty good. The rest of the people didn't seem to care. But the one guy, he was pretty funny. Everyone go listen to that. Patreon.com/phone losers.
Dying. Dying, Brad.
Hey, you're dying.
Not literally, Brad. Idiot.
Darn it.
But, yeah, thanks for sending me that. Since I can't listen to hobosodes anymore. For some reason. Even though I pay you $5 every month, Brad.
What? Why can't you?
What kind of hobo podcast is this?
What are you talking about? Everyone else can.
I don't know why the link doesn't work, but yeah, that was a funny episode. thanks for using those numbers.
You're welcome.
Yeah, I guess that's the only one I'll ever listen to.
Haha, so, yeah. Sucks to be
good
you.
Good job, Brad.
And if you're having problems, you know, send me an email. Tell me what the problem is. I'll get it figured out for you, hopefully. But it works for everyone else, you big dummy. And that is the last voicemail on today's episode. So thank God the show is finally over. I'm sorry, everyone. You probably thought this one would never end. I do way too many shows now. They're too long. I'll try to cut back on the shows. Speaking of shows, though, I did another Brad's Cactus Shack yesterday. And it's up on the Patreon for free, patreon.com/phonelosers. If you want to go listen to that, I read the police report for a thing I did in 1993 to a 7-Eleven. It was kind of amusing, I think. Okay, thanks for listening, everyone. Thank you, Effin' Reality, for being a sponsor of today's show. Thanks to all the new people who've signed up on Patreon lately, including the Smashing Pumpkins. Your music's okay, I guess. And Dwayne, S-T-E, or does that stand for Stee or Sweet? I don't know. And Dan M, and Mr. Very Mean, and Daniel G. Thanks, everyone, for signing up on the Patreon. Oh, and somebody signed up on not the Patreon. Alexander H signed up on the website like a damn weirdo. Thanks, Alexander H, for supporting the show at phonelosers.org/cactus. Here's some music by the Pool Boys. This is Squeegee Buff.
Peeing the freezer, not a belly pizza, Long Beach Greaser. Really wanna squeeze this good girl player, downtown flavor. More than anything you can save, your time is changing. Please don't hang me, I just really wanna know the feeling. Wish to wait wild, rubbing red rags, buckaboo bile, terry cloth tax, turn the G door, looking for a score, sleeping on the floor, happy to the core like a chimney sweep. Bumming to the beat, dancing the heat, city living on the street, buying movies to the meat, rocking beach and chic. About the time for a beautiful shine, I can spit down for a really good time, really good time.
Yo, it's Baby Rappy, turn around, let me sing a song. So sing along as I clean the pond, I'll work for Harry Armstrong.
Yeah.
And for my city, I'm putting it on strong. From dusk till dawn, that duck's still long, I'm super strong when I cut the lawn. I'm the pool boy, I got the pool tools, mesh pool nets, and I flex with the mitt breath, dressed in the fishnet, spandex, man sweat, open up the steam grate, balance out the pH.
Yeah, that's right, pool boys!
I'm so handsome, see me on the Samsung, cleaning out your pool, feeling like Ted Danson, dancing. Old ladies, I'm romancing, tantric mantra, girl, you fancy, thrusting.
Yeah,
it's
right.
A must that I'm busting, trust me, guts get mushy when I'm lusting, guffling, lunch me, huffing, puffing, slap you on the ass.
Don't hush me, hussy.
I'm so handsome, hand you some bland gum, trash that's done, useless when the flavor's gone. But my flavor's strong, ding dong, super long, wedding ring on, screaming yes when it's so wrong. Flex, then I glow wrong, but let me switch the tools up. And if they hate, just let them hate, watch the money pool up. New butt tune up, thrust it back, rub the juices on my mustache just for laughs. Oh snaps, hold back, door slams and the floor creaks. Honey, I'm home, like, oh shit, fold the sheets, roll the meat, sleek and sneak into my pool truck. I'm the pool boy, and I don't give a fuck.
Not a pool boy, but a squeegee man. Been imbued with powers that you don't understand. So move your ass to dance, wiggle in your pants. Give a giggle to your middle and right in Comic Sans. I heighten the demands, now throw up your hands. Bombshell in the room, got atomic plans. Hopefully romance, probably a chance. Forget about the cans and do the squeegee prance. Squeegee and squeeze it, Mario Luigi. Don't leave it, relieve it, don't try and deceive it. Squeeze it, appease it, you know you really need it. I know you won't believe it, cause you clearly don't conceive it. Believe you got the feeling that herpes sores are healing, and the scabs are peeling, mainly better by the million.
Making the neighborhood look like hobos.